Okay, this is Mama Pat and Rosie. Rosie's going to rest a while, and then we're going to see if we can't paint on glass. Okay, Rosie? You want to lay back down and let Daddy see if we can paint on glass? Y'all can't see her, but she's wanting me to stop and do something with her. But we're going to let her just lay down in Mama Pat's lap and rest. Okay, I got some glare on my glass, and my son's not here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start this off. And I'm going to start it off like I would any other. I'm going to outline. I'm going to do some outlining. And I'm going to start with my leaves. I'm going to just get to where the darkest. That's not dark enough. Go ahead and add a little bit more blue to that. Okay, let's add a dab of red. Red dulls it. But I guess more like it. Well, that ain't gonna matter to mine by the time we get through anyway. Yeah, that's what we need. When you're putting your paint down, you just look at your print that you got underneath it. Okay, what it is I've got the print underneath the glass. And then I'm going to paint the colors that I see through the glass. There's a little bit of dark in the leaves. Right here is the... I forgot what you call that little thing coming out from under the rose. I intend to do this one all on video, but not one video. It'll take a couple or more. Always start at the top of your page of your glass and come down, because if you don't, start at your bottom, and your hand's gonna be scrubbing your paint. The thing of it is, when you are doing the top and you move over, you have to be real careful and not get your hand in that over there. Now remember, these leaves are not all dark green. So just put in the dark where you see it. This is a little bud here. It's got a little bit of green in it. A little bit of dark green in it. Here's another leaf. It's got a little bit of dark in it. And this leaf is pretty much outlined with dark green. They all have veins, some of them on the bottom, some of them on the top. This is a little bud. It's got one of them little hoods on it. It's not all dark, though. This leaf is... it's got a lot of dark on it. Not sure. Okay, this is a leaf. This is a little white bud right here. I'm going to go ahead and take that in. I'm going to take that little white bud in because I see it now. Might not see it later. We can get them little pink ones. Mix us up some white and some red. And get a little pink bud, and here's a little pink bud. And here's one on this side. And this one's got some white and pink mixed. You want to get that pink and that white blended together because it's all the same. It's all the same bud. You don't want it to look like two different things. Okay, I'm gonna wash my brush and I'm gonna get some more green. Outline this right here. There's a little leaf here. It's a light color. This one's dark here. Excuse me. Got up this morning with a coughing and I really started praying. Because usually when I start coughing, it's a sign of something going on in my lungs. So I just started praying and God just took care of it. Then my back started hurting. I said, Lord, I just need to be able to move around. So I started moving around. We go one step. God will go the mile with us. Let's just show God that we'll get up and we will try. Sometimes we don't feel like that we're gonna make it. Excuse me. We just feel like we're not gonna make it. But if we get up and and try, then God will just go them other steps with us. still be doing things that we didn't think we could do that day. When I got a fever, I get real sleepy. All I want to do is sleep. And I'm just about going to do it. But if somebody didn't wake me up, I would probably just sleep my life away. But I've always got somebody that cares enough about me to wake me up, tell me, okay, you can't just lay there. You got a fever, but you can't just lay there. You got to move around. Okay, we're gonna put some light green in there, but not that light. We don't want it white, we want it light. We want it light green. If you see me going over that way, over this way, that's where my water is. Getting them leaves, you blend that dark into that light, but don't get rid of all your dark. Just make sure that your leaf comes together out of the leaf, not just of something light and something dark. I'm doing this a little fast. You can do it slower at home. I could do it slower if I wasn't on video. We got some real light. Oh, leaves almost white in the background. This is a leaf. You don't want to lose your dark that you put in. But you want to go close enough to it that you can tell that it's part of the leaf. That's one of them real light ones there. Yeah, we got some real light ones in the background. We're going to take our white. We're going to bring it down. Green is almost white. And then we're going to put this in here. There's some right here. There's some right here. There's some right here. And right here. I can't get quiet, and I can't talk. Rosie don't want me to get quiet. Every time I get quiet, she starts grunting. Okay, here's some right here. We need some little veins in there. Okay. I think I see a little bud that we didn't get. And it's right here. So while I'm here, I'm going to paint this center of this flower. And there is some red right here. Is it pink or red or brown? It's red and brown in them roses. This, rose over here is purple. It's got some brown in it. And then it's got light. It's got light, medium, and dark purple. And it's got white. It's got a little brown up in here. I got a piece of tape over it there, holding it down. I'm going to have to paint, guess it, what I'm painting there. Okay, now when we, let's see, we got, all right, we've just been 20 minutes. So we'll see what we can do with this rose. We painted this rose yesterday. We're going to try it again today. Okay, we're going to need some real light brown. gonna get our brown. Gonna put us a little bit of white in it. Right in here. That yellow turns to brown because of the way the light hits it. And we need it lighter. Lighter brown. And get this bottom part done where the light's shining on it. Just touching these up here. Okay, we're going to get some light brown, and we got to get it darker than what we had it just then. And we're going to go up here. We're going to fill in. Move my head around and around to see where I am because of the glare on it. I had already started before I realized that Tommy was not here to help me set my lights different. Okay, we got some light here. Some right there, some right there. Okay, we got a little bit of yellow in here that we didn't need. And I want to put another little coat of yellow. And then, petals are. And petals needs a little bit more definition. Especially the yellow ones. Okay, now we're going to have to mix our purple. What we're going to do is we're going to take blue and red and mix it together. We'll have your dark purple to start with. put just a little bit more blue because it's too reddish. Let's see what we can do now. Okay, we take some right here. We can pick us up some white and put there and see what happens. Okay, that's what we want in the middle tone. That's what we want in the dark tone. And then we want a lighter purple, lighter lavender, and then a white. Okay, let's get this dark in. Not too much of that medium on my brush, so I got the medium. Oops. One good thing about glass, you can wipe the paint off of it. Put your dark in where you see it, mainly the lines under your petals, where your petals go in. This one's a little dark. It's a little dark. Okay, we're going to get some of that medium tone now. Put it in here. Medium right here. Medium. Medium right here. Okay, this is going to be lighter. So we want to put just a little bit more white to our lavender that we've got already. See if that's going, that's not light enough. We want a little bit more lighter. Alright, now we're going to get our white. It's really going to be pink because we don't want it stark white. But we want it to look white on the flower. We want it to look like sunshine. where the sun's hitting it. Just in spots. This is going to be dark under here because this is where the leaf is, so we're going to go back and get this up some dark. And put it under there. Okay, now to tail. We're going to see what it looks like. It's like this on the back side. You can see all those streaks, all those outlines that you made. You can see this side, and you can see all the places that I left out. But you can go back. You look at it good. And I think the main part is our leaves. We go back and we can set it back in like we had it. Then we can touch up, because we kept all of our mixes together. We got our light and our dark green. We want to make sure that we got everything hanging in. If your light, make sure you got a good light or you won't have a glare on it like I do. And I hope you got the basic of it, the gist of it. Dryer sheet, white tissue paper, you got to treat it real tender. But as long as you've got your print that you want to use, you can put it under glass, you can put it under plastic, wrap, anything that you can see through it. And then your glass, your dryer sheet, or your white tissue paper, whatever you paint on. If it's clear, then you can paint your painting that you want to paint. I'm not through with this one, and I would love to see one that you do. And I'm gonna, my time has run out, so until next time, may y'all be blessed.